Hello, BG's Mastermind here for another how-to video. Today, I'm going to be showing you how to use the world border command. So, let's get started. First, we have world border add 10. What this is going to do, it's going to add 10 blocks of distance to the current world border size. And there's also an optional second number you can add as a time, and this is in ticks, so 60 would be 3 seconds that it takes for it to go that 10 blocks. Now we can push this, but we're not gonna see anything, so we'll move on to the next ones until we can actually see the world border first, and I'll come back to these to show them. So next is world border center 50-50. This is the world coordinates, the X and the Z. And this marks the center of the world border. By default, this is 0, 0, or it might be 0.5, 0.5, and I'm changing it to 50-50. So we can press that one now. Still not really going to see anything change, but it's in the center of the world now, or a little bit off of the center. Next, we have world border damage amount 5, and what this is going to do, if a player is able to get outside of the world border, they will start to take damage, and this is how much damage they will take per block. It increases, so we have it set to 5, so each block out is going to increase by 5. The first block is only going to do 5 hit points of damage. The second block will do 10, I believe. And so on. Then you can also have a buffer. This is how many blocks you can go out past the world border before taking damage. So we're setting it so you can go 50 blocks past the world border before you'll start taking damage. You can press those two. Alright, now we have world border get. This is gonna tell us how big the world border currently is. So we push that, and we see it's at its default size, which is 600 million, I think. Or 60 million actually. Next, we have world border set 10. And this is the same as the add, but it's setting it rather than adding it. And same thing, you can, for the time it takes for it to change to that size. So let's push this. Now you see our screen is going red, and the world border is right over here. And now I can't interact with any of the command blocks, so I'm actually going to have to manually change it and go to set it to 100, 300. There we go. The world border is right there. Now we have world border warning distance. We're setting this to 10. What this will do is it will start making your screen turn red when you come within this distance of the world border. So the screen's going to get redder and redder the closer you get. So once we're right on top of it, it's going to be the most, but it's going to start turning red at 10 blocks away. So we can push that. And there's also a warning time, which I believe is the time it takes for the red overlay to like fade in. And we're going to set that to 3 seconds. So we come over by the world border here. You see screen starts getting red. And if we go outside the world border in survival, after 50 blocks, we're going to start taking damage. And you see, it does the damage pretty quickly. So, going outside the world border is probably not something you want to do. And now I can just go back to the beginning here and show off these over here. So the center is by default 0, 0. We can shift that. And now it's not as clear to see. We have to go a bit further. There it is. That was this one. And we can change the time it takes for it to shrink. Oh, it is in seconds, so it's gonna go down slowly to in 60 seconds. So a minute. And it's a And we see it turn green because it's expanding. You can also reduce it using set to shrink it. And let's actually do that. So set's over here. We're going to shrink it down to 10 and 60. And let's do 10 seconds. And you see it's red because it's shrinking. And here we are. So that's gonna be, that's everything. I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to like and subscribe, and I'll see you on the next video. Bye-bye.